Lisa, thanks for joining me here today.
You're very well. It's good to be here.
So just before I start bombarding you with questions, I thought I'd just kind of recap why you're here. Mm-hmm. So my team likes to interview local business owners or businesses that service the Leaside neighborhood.
Right.
Just kind of interview them about what it is that they do, what they like about the neighborhood, and what kind of offerings they have that are perhaps different from others.
Right.
So I'll dive right into it.
Okay.
So I obviously know what you do, but maybe you can explain for anybody watching this, what do you do? Could you describe your business?
Okay, basically with Superior Home Inspectors, we inspect houses and condos, from very old houses to brand new condos. We also inspect for mold and new construction inspection.
Okay.
We use the infrared camera. So the infrared camera, what it does is it shows heat. So as we scan around the room, we see different things, hot, cold, and when you have water, say you have water in a ceiling coming through, dripping from a bathtub, could be pooling on top of the drywall, and you see the stain there. So when you look at it from the side that's stained, it's obvious and you see it visually. But when you're looking, say, up at a ceiling below the bathtub, you don't see anything on that piece of drywall. But when you look at it with the infrared camera, you can see that cool spot.
Amazing.
So that's the moisture on the other side making cool.
Right, because of the thickness of drywall, I mean, if there's not an enormous amount of water, it's not going to penetrate all the way through.
That's right. It just influences the temperature.
Interesting.
And that's what we're seeing there.
Oh, very cool.
Feature of that. That's one of our advantages of using that. So now to get back to your question about what services we do. So we also do mold investigation, sometimes, usually by a homeowner. So not necessarily as part of a purchase or sale, but somebody has a concern about health, or they see something visually, or they smell something, and they wonder, do I have mold in my house?
Okay.
And so we can come in, do basically air quality testing and surface quality sampling. So then the lab analyzes those samples for mold spores, type and quantity. And then with that, we can give them an idea, what do you have here? And also, as part of that service, because we're home inspectors, we examine all the parts of the home that could influence mold development.
Right.
So things like ventilation, leaks from heating and cooling, plumbing leaks, roof leaks, attic, basement, all those things where moisture can accumulate and cause mold to grow. So
my understanding properly that you're not, I mean, most people, when they think of home inspectors, they think, okay, I'm buying or I'm selling, and at that moment, that snapshot in time, I need you to come in, basically give a thumbs up or thumbs down about, you know, all the components of a home.
Right.
But you're saying that if somebody's lived in a home for 2 years, five years, 10 years, they might say, oh, there's something a little funny.
Yeah.
I think a lot of people would think of, I'm going to call a handy person.
Yes.
But you're saying you guys are actually going in and getting involved then as well.
Yes. So that's a small but very important part of our business. I mean, most of it is the buy-sell transaction.
Sure.
But the homeowners who are conscientious about their homes and they're concerned about maintenance. And if they have a plumbing leak, you know, they'll call a plumber. That's
sure.
pretty straightforward. But say they don't have an idea about what the problem is. They just know there's a problem. So that's where we could come in and do troubleshooting from all angles. Because we're not a tradesperson, we don't have an interest in selling them repairs.
True.
So we give them an independent assessment of what's going on.
So we dove in quite deep very quickly.
Mm-hmm.
Let me rewind and start asking you some more basic questions.
Okay.
What made you decide to get into this business?
Well, I was working for a company designing water treatment tanks.
Okay.
And before that, I worked for an engineer doing underwater inspection. I had my commercial diving qualifications.
Ah.
So anyway, my mother was selling her house.
Okay.
And she had Alzheimer's and she had to move into, you know, retirement home. And as part of the transaction, we had the house inspected.
Yes.
So when I saw the report, I looked at it and I thought, wow, that's something I could do. So then I got into, you know, the home inspection training, and with my background, which was already based in inspection, reporting from an engineering perspective, then I could apply that to houses.
Sure.
So that's, and I liked being self-employed. So as a company, we have multiple inspectors.
Yes.
And I help manage those. But we are fairly independent. We set our own schedules, which means we're available a lot of different times,
sure.
weekends and so on. So it's kind of a out of the 9-to-5 office routine, which I really enjoy.
So you're it's almost like you guessed what I was going to ask you next. I was going to ask you what motivates you and what drives you to do what you do.
Right. So it was that turning point of when I realized, oh, the maintenance we could have done on my mother's house in advance, you know, before selling.
Sure.
That made me think about the more proactive aspect of it. So in the home inspection is not just about the sale, it's about helping owners maintain their house.
Sure.
Because, as you know, real estate's one of the biggest transactions or investments you do.
Of course.
And you don't wanna, you know, just let the condition of your house slide. You can, the value can go down thousands of dollars when you don't take care of stuff.
Absolutely.
And a little proactive maintenance. So that's what, in our inspections, we have lots of details to give people the guidance to take care of their house and protect the value.
I don't know if I've ever told you this, but as you know, many home inspections now are prepared digitally.
Mm-hmm.
I've been doing this long enough, I'm sure, and you too, that I remember when it used to come in a binder.
Yes.
And so because of those days when it came in a binder, I actually advised most of my home buyers, print out the PDF,
right,
hole punch it,
right,
put it in a binder, and that will form the basis and the beginning of your home guide, your guide to owning this home.
That's right.
So all the reminders about filter changes and when you have somebody come and service your hot water tank or your furnace, all that goes in there, and then you've got that date on that home inspection, you know, January 1st, 2019.
That's right.
Says, you know, hey, in 3 years, so and so component is, you're gonna have to start keeping an eye on it.
Yeah.
So you can kind of build a maintenance calendar. So absolutely, exactly what you're saying.
Yeah, so nowadays we don't do inspections with pen and paper.
Yeah.
We do them, I actually have an application on my phone.
Yes.
So I can take notes there. Many of them are preloaded.
Mm-hmm.
So it's already been.
Oh, like a drop down menu?
Yeah. So we can pick and choose. It makes the report writing faster. And it gets a lot of detail in there in the field, and then it would take photos right in the phone, in addition to the regular camera and the infrared camera.
Sure.
So that's three sets of photos that we compile.
Awesome.
To report. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
So, to what has surprised you the most, being a business owner or business manager?
I guess, well, it's all about, in the beginning, getting your feet under you, getting clients and so on. And also dealing with the shifting real estate market.
Sure.
You know, when there was a certain time when it was very much a seller's market.
Yes.
And we ended up doing actually most of our inspections for sellers. So to help them prepare. And then when it came back down to more of a buyer's market, it depends where you are. But,
sure.
I guess the shifting in the market, but it's fairly, it has a bit of a routine in terms of seasonality,
okay.
which is nice. It can be, you can sort of rely on the fact that it's going to be slow in December
okay.
and slower in August. Everybody wants to go away.
Sure.
But there's always business, you know, popping up.
Yeah, people
here
are
and
still
there.
Transacting.
Yeah.
Maybe just not at the same volume.
That's right.
Gotcha.
That's
so
right.
So the seasonality is something you have to adjust to.
Yeah, and it actually works quite well for me because, you know, you like to vacation with family in
sure.
December and go out and enjoy the seasons in the summer.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
So what's something that most people would not know about your business?
I think they don't realize how much work's involved in a home inspection, and some things like the infrared camera, people don't know how that works.
Right.
So, for instance, the report writing takes at least as long as the on-site work.
Oh, wow.
So that, because we have to be very careful, and, you know, we don't want to to either miss something or, you know, have something incomplete.
Sure.
So sifting through the data that you've collected in the field, which is quite extensive, requires a lot of revision and review and filling out. So that's something that's a lot of work.
Interesting.
It just doesn't end when we're finished with the site work.
Yeah, no, I know. Yeah. I've trained my team well that if they're doing an inspection with you, they must book off a minimum of 3 hours. I know I've even asked you, I said, Lisa, can you do it in like two and a half or a little press? And you're like, no, I can't. I need the 3 hours.
Happens all the time.
I bet.
So, yeah.
Even some listing agents, when we're calling the book, mm-hmm. like, okay, what do you need? An hour and a half, 2 hours? Mm-hmm. I go, no, three and a half.
Yeah.
Minimum. You must get a lot of compliments from your customers. What would you say is something that you hear the most that they love about your business?
I think that at the end of the inspection on site, they usually say, wow, you were so thorough. Because they won't know really what to expect when we start. Mm-hmm. But after we've gone through it, and like you said, the time that it takes, and all the detail that we're looking at, they're impressed, they're relieved. It doesn't matter what we find. Mm-hmm. I mean, it obviously it matters, but they're relieved, whatever the findings are, that we've looked into it in so much
just
detail.
Just having that knowledge.
Yeah,
there's not
yeah.
a big question mark anymore.
That's right. We're not just, you know, walking through casually and taking a few notes.
What are some of your greatest challenges as a business owner and manager?
Well, I guess the time spent doing administration, managing more inspectors, training,
HR.
It's
killer.
It all takes more time.
Sure.
So time that, you know, takes, it's a soft cost.
Sure.
You know, so that's I guess our main challenge in a business sense.
So what is it that you love the most about Leaside?
Leaside, it's a pretty neighborhood in terms of the cluster of older houses in the middle, the tree-lined boulevards.
Are you an architecture geek like me?
I kind of am. I wish I had got, you know, part of me says, you should have gone into architecture, you know?
Yeah.
So I love looking at the old houses and the mature trees. It's just a very pretty area to drive through.
It's true.
Yeah, so that and all the shops on Bayview. You know, lots of different things there, neat stuff. The library in that
little
area.
Oh yeah, the local Leaside Library.
Yeah, it's a pretty place to hang out. And what else? There was, the ravine.
Yes.
There, it's pretty again, fall colors, trails.
Sounds like
so
you probably
right.
find some excuses to go for a walk in the summer and the fall through Leaside sometimes.
Yeah, we do, we do. We go through the trail system. Try a different one each year. And
awesome.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So from positive to not negative, but what can be improved, is there anything that you would improve about the neighborhood?
I would have to say, well, as you know, the subway line along Eglinton is going along. It's mm-hmm. taking a while, as those things do.
Yeah.
So traffic along Eglinton can be a snarl, it would be nice to see it all done.
Yeah. At least, I mean, as positive a person as I try to be, we're probably in for another 5 years.
Yeah.
But it will be nice, because if we can get some of the congestion off the neighborhood streets, the residential streets with,
yes.
you know, families and kids and pets, it'll be nice to get all that back onto Eglinton.
Yeah. And, you know, I find, though, the West End much worse.
Really?
Past, on the other side of Young Street around Bathurst.
Oh,
driving
going towards
through
the
there. It's crazy.
It's true. In fact, yeah, it gets down to one lane, and you don't, I think because of the alley, you can't actually divert around.
That's right.
So
yeah.
Really
it bottlenecks right in
yeah.
there. Yeah.